Keep talking.
So he came in a few weeks back, and she had put this gentian violet on him. So we scrubbed him off. Addie scrubbed him for like 30 minutes. But if
it's the purple stuff. That's what all the farmers call it. I put that purple stuff on the dot.
He looks good. Don't look like he's infected.
Good and weighty. Of course, he did just blow us a booger there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the beeswax. What is in there?
I don't know what that is.
Here, you do the camera.
A remote control till we get out. A couple of remote controls till we get done.
Not the remote controls.
All right, bye.
No one will be able to watch TV.
That's so funny.
All right, this actually looks like it's doing some pretty decent healing. There's some questions in here that'll fall out after a while, but yeah, this guy can be set free.
Sweet.
They survive worse than this on a regular basis without our help.
All right. Well, what we'd like to do though before we release
him. Why is your arm doing that though?
Yeah, his arm has been acting weird the whole time. Why is he blowing boogers? Oh my gosh.
He's quite overhydrated.
Wow.
He got bugs on his face. Ooh. Hey!
He go.
Don't you be doing that.
Bite you.
Don't you be doing that.
Look at him, how cute.
That is cute. Good color. Gladys looks good.
I could shove D-Worm in there real quick, couldn't I?
You got something up in there real quick?
Why not? Let me find it. Hold on. We may as well while we can. Little dab will do ya. Whoa! Okay, give me that back. Okay. Oh, they've got a grip, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's going to cut that in half.
Nah.
There we go. Got it. How did that taste like? Banana?
Banana. Did you like it? Yes, I did. Want some more? No, I don't.
Okay, see, we would be getting done quick in here, but y'all got to play.
Exactly. It's what we do. May as well enjoy this. All right. Except for the purple stuff. We're going to set you free.
Awesome.
Okay, next.
All right. Leg injury.
4-9 Pascula leg injured. Injury.
Daddy, you mark a number 3 on there for me?
Eee.
Did his leg come off? This is the one that I think needed his leg amputated for real. Like big time.
Come on, stick your head out of here.
Is his leg in there? Maybe him out.
I see some fuzzy looking thing in here that could be his foot.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty much going to come off.
It's no charge for this amputation. Is there occasionally a freebie that I will do? With That's just bad. Okay.
Are these your little baby?
No, it's like sesame seeds.
No, these are baby something. There's antennae.
Yep. Those are little creatures. Okay, we're going to have to scrub the heck out of him. I was gonna scrub the heck out of him. He has no nasal passages.
Yes, he does.
He does.
Yeah.
They're just not apparent right now.
Are we gonna save those little creatures for you?
I can't.
No. I need the big maggots for the study. Well, this is about to turn into some sequestrums and fall off. But there's maggots in here, see them?
Oh, wow.
Oh.
Right there, so.
But they're the wrong kind. Those are just maggot maggots.
Oh, wait a minute.
Not the maggots, but the maggot maggots.
We need to get those out of there.
We're probably going to have... Or is that going to fall off naturally?
Is this a euthanasia case?
No, I don't think so.
Are the maggots doing a service, then, that with if they're not the other ones?
No, that's not doing a service.
Thank you, veterinarian.
He's going to agree.
But
you know, leeches do services, and sometimes they use maggots to, in Mexico.
Let's sedate him and clean that out. Can we just go ahead and do that?
I don't think he needs to be sedated. This guy will let you in there.
Well, okay.
Just put him in line for the ones you wash up tomorrow.
No, we're going to get those maggots out now. Me and Addie got to get them out now. That really doesn't look so bad, does it?
There we go.
Thank you, babe.
Give me your foot.
Oh, we need some peroxide. Include it.
I'm
It's Jamie. Are we talking 2% where you're doing surgery on turtles? Okay. Okay, stick it in the pile. Yay. All right, stick it in your pile. I'll send Mom down there tomorrow.
This guy has to be cleaned up.
Hang on, Addie.
I clean him up. This is going to close over in here. You see the skin is actually closing up over it right there? In the corner. See right there, there, and there? All right, so all that's going to close up.
That's a natural suture.
So,
All natural.
Yeah. Don't ask me nothing.
You heard her. Her duck's getting gas.
What?
Okay.
All right, we need to do a fecal. Chances are her duck has an overgrowth of clostridium, which is or a lot of E. coli, which are all produce gas in the duck's colon. Okay. So
he said we need to do a fecal on the ducks because that they can get.
Or we could just put them through some amoxicillin or some clavamox for about a week.
Amoxi. Start them both on amoxi over there. I sent you that 400 milligrams for 5 mils.
Before we start talking about duck gas.
Yep.
Duck farts.
And I have more. I'll send more too. So.
Anyways, a piece of bone there, piece of bone there. I just pulled some sequestrums off. One of these, just that's a piece of dried bone that had already healed beneath it. So that's going to dry up again and be plucked off just like that. And even just be healed over on its own. Probably be able to walk on it too because there's just enough callus underneath here. Okay, so you just need some more TLC. All right. Plus good video too. Hi, Ma. Okay. This guy was brought in. He had around the necrotic part of his beak over here. His rampotica. And it turns out that it seemed to heal pretty well. But I think the best analogy I've heard so far is look, he's been chewing tobacco and actually has some.
Him Copenhagen.
I hate.
His name is officially
smokeless tobacco, by
Copenhagen.
No, it's not. I hate anything to do with dip.
We'll call him Marlboro.
No.
Bye
bye.
No, who's the guy from the cigars? Cuba.
George Burns.
Juan Pablo.
Cuba. The Cuban dictator. That's what we'll call him. We'll call him Juan Pablo.
Anyway, so chances are.
Bachelor. He wasn't doing very well on The Bachelor, by the way. Juan Pablo.
Wrong one, Missy.
So anyway. this part of bone right here is actually falling away as a sequestrum. It's probably going to actually scar in and make some keratinization underneath here. His eyes actually went fine and was very clear. He will, if he tries to eat something like a strawberry, he'll have that little squirt out of the left side of his mouth.
Don't make me laugh because the video was shaking. That's
funny. But this guy could probably be released or, you know, at least put outside and to see how well he does.
That's what we'll do.
Good shot.
Outdoor enclosure for a little bit just to see what happens. How about that?
Kind of like a pre-release.
Yeah.
You're on parole.
Turtle's on parole.
Put his little anklet right here on his back foot. That when he gets out,
we'll know.
Please set me free.
Oh, God. It's going to be a long night. Because she don't know no better.
Okay, told this turtle was raised by humans somewhere in some domestic domicile. Anyway, if you look at this turtle, you can actually tell how it should be round straight up and over as opposed to like flattened on top and it goes back down on here. It's like Bertha. She got some junk in this trunk. and she's so not afraid of humans. This is her porn post. She has her own Facebook page.
This is how it should look.
Yeah, that's how it should look.
Bless
minus the holes in the shell, but anyway, These are an awesome species. They've got great, a lot of personality. They're, compared to some other tortoises, they really take care of. The bad news is, it's back to the porn post. The bad news is, if they're not done exactly correctly, you know, as naturally as possible, then they're going to get these growth anomalies. And the growth anomalies can have all kinds of problems, from having a hard time dropping eggs to mating. If the male doesn't have a decent enough dent on the bottom, then he won't be able to mount the female a little bit more properly. But anyway, this is a girl, so.
So she could have problems. She's eventually.
Good. She could. She really could.
Okay, look at all this extra.
So we're not going to, we'll place her in an educational facility. How does that
no,
sound?
No, I mean, set her free. I mean, she has problems. She doesn't. I mean, actually, okay. We think evolutionarily speaking, she can carry more eggs than the average turtle.
There you go.
We just don't know how well she can get them out.
That's what happens when you have more junk in your trunk.
See, you can do this too. I don't like it. Oh, get the pose. Hey, baby.
I'm stuck.
Don't touch me like that. Jerry could be watching.
Don't
do that. I've got a captain. Well, all right. There. What is? Give me some history on this guy.
I don't know.
Back leg issue.
What does it say?
That's all it says.
No right. Date.
No.
Okay.
Give me. Well, we got some muscle atrophy.
Frog legs.
Those legs look fine to me.
Yeah, a little atrophy, but they're good.
Look at your little face.
He'll build up some muscle out in a while.
To her.
It was a chew toy.
Sure was.
I see that, and there's also some scar tissue on the back of this foot, and that's going to heal fine too. So another one that can be released.
Yeah.
Yep, and that's where these came from. These are the puncture wounds. I'm going to put, packed it with Silvadine.
Silvadine is the best stuff in the world. It really is.
Yeah, it's going to be a sequestrum. That's all going to fall off. Okay.
Okay.
Another one.
Sweet.
Okay, this is one of those young baby turtles that we had a while back. And this, we pulled maggots from this guy's neck before? Mm-hmm. Is that what you're telling me? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Could be scar tissue, maybe?
Well, it's something hard in there. We're going to check it out.
Maybe it's that nasty gunk that they leave
behind. Geechee, 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 sucker.
Oh, the school already said that Attic could job shadow.
Really?
So cool. Whenever you get over to Happy Tales, it'd be perfect. Would Doc Griffin be okay with that?
Yeah.
I'll get Addie some Michigan scrubs.
She'll be really welcome then.
Doc Griffin with the Michigan State. Oh, yeah, that's right. Ooh. Is that one of them biggins?
No. Oh, come on, little buddy. Give me your head.
What are you looking for? Right there.
What are you looking for, Daddy? The ones that have the little...
These ones right there.
And there it is. Just dirt and
debris. Yay! Addie, grab some flush, please, ma'am. Let's arrange with some flush.
Oh, I was going to give you the tiny little...
What is that?
A syringe. You can suck up some of that chlorhex right there.
Come on, little buddy.
Aren't they strong little things?
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Fresh.
I need is
fresh syringe.
This guy. Mm-hmm.
Just, yep, suck about half.
Do you need more light?
No, we're good.
Okay. If you do, I've got a floor lamp.
Oh. That'd be like a micro pus can. Right there.
Yeah, I saw it too, Ed.
All right, sorry, little buddy. We had to get that popped. Just to give it like a big zit.
A healthy shell.
Actually, you're right. Nice and sturdy.
How much longer for that one?
I'd give him a few more weeks just to let this area here heal up one more time. It had sand in it. All that stuff that pulled out of here was sand.
Okay.
Oh, we could have had a pearl.
Yes, the turtle's name.
Turtle pearl. All right, here you go.
Pearl.
Pearl is going to be kept in captivity for a little bit longer, just long enough for this pocket here where the maggots were once held to close up a little bit more completely. See how it was just like a zit right there?
Gunk.
Okay. So we degunked it. And you got like a skin fold over your head, but
it's
we'll just let that go.
Turtle, huh? Fat, huh?
They're all cute.
Yep. All right.
That means you're working the hardest.
We're having some success.
Is it deviated? It's an anatomy joke.
He's not stupid. He's fun. I'm picking on my man crush.
Oh. Yeah, there ain't no picking on the man crush. Boom. Hey, what
the? Alright, yeah, this guy could be set free. I mean, what's going to happen for this guy? Which is actually, since he was injured, the tip of the nose there has been taken off. It should have a sharper point that comes out about that far. So that much of his nose has been removed. So what happens is he won't be able to close off his nostrils, but they can actually get water in their face. It's not a problem because their mouth is not completely sealed. So anyway, he would just be one of those turtles that would hang out in the shallows. Would not breathe as secretly as the other turtles of his own species.
Cool, very cool.
And then he'll still be able to hunt by going underneath and opening up his mouth. So.
Very cool. That's Mr. Lin's little find there. That's a fat turtle, too. Look at that.
Itchy, gitchy, gitchy.
He's like, I don't play your games. I am a Russian turtle.
Probably a male, too.
Very cool.
How do you tell on them?
Their tail.
Is it the tail?
Yeah.
He's fat. Look at turning around, everybody can see how fat. Look at that. Mr. Meal.
This is not malnourishment here.
We definitely
take care of our animals.
And I like the fact that they eat while in rehab. That's the most important thing.
Well, what's really important is that they at least get directions to a fat farm after they leave here.
We have him signed up for Jenny Craig once he's gone.
This is Nate. Not a toy! Exclamation. Isn't that a cute name?
Let me see. No.
He had a tiny, tiny little boo-boo somewhere, and we just hang on to him for a little while until he could be released. That's it.
Well, he does it surgery, too.
And it looks perfectly fine, doesn't it? He goes back home to Gulfport. Miss Tina will pick him up.
Yeah.
I think we should put...
Yeah, well, that's closed over.
Should we put some Silvadine on it to send him on his way? Because it seals up, you know?
Yeah.
Or some beeswax.
He's not aquatic. It won't bind as much.
Really?
I tried it.
The good news is this is all soft tissue and it's all closed. Actually, give this guy a few more weeks just to give that some more granulation tissue in there. That way he won't have maggots in his back.
Okay. A couple weeks for him, too.
She was gardening.
Yeah, this guy's still bleeding a little bit. See what right there? We've just been playing with him. His blood pressure went up, and look, he's still bleeding. So we'll hold him a little bit longer.
Okay.
But, yeah, this is a cool. I love these guys. These are like mud and musk turtles. These are some of your smaller species of turtles. What makes these guys so cool is they're actually kind of relatively close kin to your alligator snappers and stuff. You notice how the face and the head's pretty much equally shaped. This guy could be 30 and 40 years old.
My goodness.
So they stay pretty small.
So how long do we want to hang on to this one?
I would just make sure that this area here is not bleeding anymore. And I would say, how long have you had him? Weeks, months?
Mud turtle. Show
April 30th. How you do that.
Okay. So probably another month to be ready to go.
I don't know if he's got the beeswax.
So 1 month. So June.
This guy has no beeswax on him.
We're going to say.
No, she's going to do it. But we're going to release him on the 4th of July. She wanted to show you how she does it.
Oh, okay. Please show me how you do the beeswax thing.
Daddy, can you do that?
Yeah.
I want to spill it on myself.
Addie Boo's showing Dr. Askew what's up.
What's up? You've been saving your boogers for a long time, haven't you?
Your booger smells.
Who? I think I'm going to call you honey.
Every time she sneezes, she's got beezes.
Oh, Lord Jesus. Nobody knows. All right.
The cool part about this is that whenever the water gets in there, it takes all the shit. Have you used it before?
I've never used it myself. I know other people have. You know, I just...
The sugars go away and the wax stays and bonds.
It's amazing.
And it heals. We did one and it took, what, 6 weeks?
3.
Well, the reason that honey works so well on wounds is because it's so osmotically charged. It's got so many... it's so thick, okay, with sugar, that a lot of bacteria can't grow in that sugar.
It's like a poultice.
Yeah, actually. Kinda. So what happens is, since the wax has it in there, you're actually putting it on there, and the wax being also a protein as well sticks in that area, and because the honey's being leached out over time, keeps the bacterial growth down. It also tells the body what's normal and what's not normal. The beeswax has a different DNA than the turtle, so it would actually say, this is where we stop, the turtle stops, and the infection ends.
Love it.
So it's pretty cool shit.
Oh, nice. That was nice.
It says
pretty, pretty cool.
Yeah. It's up here somewhere.
This is Calhoun. We have the sweetest little lady who lives on Calhoun Street. Uh-huh. We've had a squirrel Calhoun, a possum Calhoun, and this is turtle Calhoun. She keeps it simple. Everything is labeled Calhoun. She's a doll, and she's making us some possum pouches right now.
Come on, open up. Open up. Open up. Get mad at the doctor. There you go. Come on. Show me who's boss. I just want to see back there.
Oh.
And see if the infection goes, if the infection's coming in and cause any internal damage to his head. Yeah, you almost got me bit.
I'm trying to hold it open for you, dude.
Oh, he'll get it open.
Oh, okay.
Watch the turtle master and learn.
Turtle whisperer. Tell him secrets.
Open it up. Open it.
Oh. There we go again.
Come on, say something. Yeah.
Ow, I got TMJ.
Oh, Lord.
Oh.
Do you need a light there?
Oh. Come on, you can do it. I know you can. Get really, really wide. That's what I want to see. Yes, you're chasing sheep's not a problem. Well, in a perfect world, I want to get that out of there.
Okay, so we're going to get him up. We're going
to bring him to the hospital. Okay. So he's a bring to the hospital.
All right, okay. Bring him to the hospital for surgery. Great, so he gets to stay with us another year. Thank you very much,
Doc. That sucker was down like this, and I manipulated it back into a normal spot. As normal as I could get.
Yeah.
There was blood supply here, so we didn't... And this little part right here, we weren't sure if that's going to go.
Well, what worries about this case, although he's not showing any signs of this, is... One, we've got some bleeding right here, so it's too soon to set this guy free. We got a major space right here. Mm-hmm. So I'd let this guy heal for another month, since he's doing so well, and we may want to come in here and debride these, with, you know, do some grinding on this area.
All right.
But the good news is...
Does that look, that looks like pus, Doc. Stop. Doesn't have a flashlight?
You guys used to have a sense of humor.
I do. I think it's hilarious.
There it is. I tell you what, that's some impressive healing so far, though. You know that?
Yeah.
From April, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Addie, I think I want you to scrub this again with some Chlorhex.
Yep.
And rewrap this with Silvadine. Okay.
And this guy's also got hinge injury on both sides.
Both hinge,
scrub
yep.
with Chlorhex and then wrap and put more Silvadine and we'll rewrap.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
I do think this is going to be here with us for a while.
Do you
want
to rewrap or leave it out to the elements since it's
in here?
Well, I mean, if you're going to pack Silvadine and stuff on it, that should be
the
fine.
The flies aren't going to...
Okay. That'd be good.
Silvadine should be fine.
Because the air will help it.
Okay, this is going to be here with us
okay.
for a bit longer.
So,
yeah.
Natty, clean him up. Nurse.
Turtle?
Okay. Here we have a small Terrapin, Carolina. The story is... What?
Oh, battery. How is that possible as heavy as this phone is?
Turn the thing over.
Turn the thing over?
Yeah. See that little button right there? Switch to the green.
Oh.
No, that's not the one. To the button. Other side.
Oh.
Right there.
Click this way.
There you go. Now you just turn.
You should have got it.
All right. Terrapin, Carolina. We've seen it. How long ago was this brought to me?
Oh, gosh. Like
a couple months.
A year.
Okay. It's been a year. All right. I don't remember it, but they tell me that all this area was still maggots, and he probably did some debriding, and I said, we'll take the leg off later. Well, now, it looks like this guy is in a chronic left-turn mode.
We might not want to record this one.
What wasn't ready. Dr. Askew said he needs to gain weight and heal.
Yeah.
It needed, that turtle was in horrible shape.
I'm innocent in this?
Yeah.
Douglas.
Anyway, what's kind of odd, and having seen this now for the first time in about a year, is there was so much soft tissue and scarring in here that this leg is like stuck and stiff. So, you know, he's in that chronic. What is it? Wait, this is left and this is right. How's that work?
Left, right. No, left.
One is straight out.
Right. So he's doing a right turn.
Yeah, he says
right turn.
I'm
slide.
Signaling for a right turn. Ooh.
It's a model.
All right, so we need to get him in, and we need to get this leg amputated.
We could call him,
or at least get some X-rays, because maybe there's some bone in here we could actually fix.
That'd
be kind of cool.
Cool,
wouldn't it?
Yeah. All right.
Today I ride the short bus. Tomorrow I pay regular price. All right, another Terrapin Carolina. Don't walk. This is DWG. Don't is his first name. Walk is his middle name, and Good is his last name. All right. This guy actually was quite catastrophically hit. This is one of those cases where I guess we were wondering if his innervation was going to come back. We were surprised at how well he could feel his back legs, but he wasn't able to push. So in other words, he can. If I grab his back leg, he can feel it. But he really has no pushing or no power. Anyway, if you see how hollow this is on the inside, I was curious to see how well this guy would heal. So we sent him here for some rehab. Obviously, he's still alive so many months later. Okay. Anyway, this guy's going to need some surgery. We have to clear away these sequestrums, figure out what's happening underneath here. Part of the reason he's having a hard time with his chronic conjunctivitis is he probably is fighting some chronic infection here. So if we clear this up, we'd be able to fix that and also get rid of some of these sequestrums on this area here. Anyway, what we'll end up doing is this guy probably is not releasable.
Right.
Okay. But this would be one of those cases where we could actually fix him up and show how our healing process goes. So we'll this will be one of those sequestrum control study things.
That's gonna be cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, his eyes are itching him and bothering him. Do we have anything here we can inject him with?
I brought was propofol.
Okay.
For quick surgeries if we needed any.
Okay.
Wait. Okay.
Yeah.
Like I said, you know, once you get all this cleared up, he'll be a much healthier creature. But in the meantime, we'll discuss getting him some antibiotics for his eyes. Probably use some tetracycline or something. Be really good, like a bath.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Got that.
All right.
There you
go. All right. The Terrapin Carolina. So far as this is a bad one. So, we're discovering this together.
Yeah, look at the shell. It's like totally askew.
Never heard that one before.
That's cool.
All right, scraping away the Silvadine.
The wonder ointment.
That stuff is the greatest stuff in the world. Absolutely the greatest stuff in the world.
Yum.
And the thing about these, this animal came in basically dead. So we wrap it up and think, okay, it's not going to make it to get to the doctor. And it does just fine. And then the shell heals crooked. But hey, at least it mends.
Yeah, he's been here 8.5 years.
Oh, boy.
I don't care what you say. That's funny. Well, Addie. This is a clean them up case. Okay. My turtle scrubber, do your thing.
Flops out.
All right, enough pet names for my daughter.
Okay, so this one's going to require some stuff.
Well, we probably should grind some of this stuff away, see what's going on underneath here.
Could we realign and wire like
we could I don't know. Realigning them at this point in time. All right, think of orthodontics.
Set,
okay,
yeah,
it's that bone's already there, but
yeah.
If we grind it, we'll be able to see.
We should call him San Andreas.
No, this is the fault.
The fault.
It's not my fault.
It's the fault.
It's his fault. That's the fault.
The car's fault.
Or asphalt.
Oh my lord! We're gonna go clean the dirt. You've been so mean today.
More proof. I've been not mean. I've been not mean, Skywalker. Sorry. I gave you a hug and I kissed your shoulder.
I don't want a hug. I'm aggravated. I'm going to punch you in the face in a minute.
All right, you two, break it up. It's the turtle time.
Save me.
Gosh, the more you pull, is that intestines coming out of there?
No, it's not intestines. It's part of his leg. There's... He's missing pieces of it.
Let's numb him and get that out of there. Don't we want to?
That's not a numbing case.
Does it propel?
Grab what I got here.
All right.
All right, got that. Okay, now.
Did you just clamp it?
Yeah, it's dead tissue. You can't feel it.
Gotcha. This is not for the squeamish.
Well, all right, this guy needs to have this part amputated, but he needs to be on some antibiotics for a bit first.
Down there too,
yeah. That's what happened was when he was hit, the car hit him on the side,
shell
in the back,
off.
Closed off on his leg.
Let go now?
Yep.
Well, the good thing is we have...
In a perfect world, I want him to have a convenient shot.
Okay, cool.
Shoot me in the bottom. Bottom of me shoot. Give me drugs.
We need a convenient injection. If I can go to Dr. Griffin tomorrow, what would be the dose that you would want him to have? Let's weigh him and you tell us. And then we will go get it. How
you,
about that?
You will weigh him, you will text me, and then I will tell you.
There's a weight right there.
You said 1.4?
1.14. Wait, 1 pound, 1.4 ounces.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow. We're doing things in the old measurements.
492 calories?
Grams.
Grams. All right. So basically about half a kilo. What you mumbling? Yes, we're still recording. Did you say a hooper nasty no-no?
What?
Did you say a hooper nasty no-no?
What is that?
Cuss word. Did you cuss, young lady? All right, another Terrapin, Carolina. I love to call these guys chew toys. It turns out some dog will pick them up and just start chewing on them. And after they start breaking through the protein coat and the keratin coat, they get to bloody bone. And this is like one of the richest chew toys there are. Nom nom, all salty and bloody and stuff. You should taste one. Just, no sense of humor. All right, anyway, wherever the bone, I got it. Wherever the bone is exposed to the air, it actually
dies.
There you go. It dies. And then what happens is beneath it, the osteoclasts and the osteoblasts do their wonderful bone work, and they actually will undermine the old bone. See, like that coming off?
Nice.
This guy's just a little bit overly moist. Once this dries, this stuff will just like peel off like... Anyway, so this guy just needs to have...
So it's like a regrowth.
This is like Dr. Ann's favorite thing in the whole world. She won't do a whole lot with turtles, but you give one of these guys in a dental pick, she will sit there and pick for hours.
But I'm going to send this to Dr. Ann.
This would be a cool one for her. Yeah, see. Dr. Ann, we hear you're the best.
Go to Dr. Ann.
Well, he's taking all the stuff off, so she ain't going to have nothing left.
Yeah, don't show the video. She'll feel like she's been cheated.
Where's this container?
Her and Abigail can work on this one, and this one probably won't be released because he's going to have so much.
Oh, yeah, that hinge is destroyed.
Yeah.
Yep, still telling me this morning if there needs to go. So see how this stuff just pops out?
How cool is that? It's, that is, that's like a new scoot.
Well, it's a protein coat, but.
That's what Yapch has on him.
I know, but look at there's coloration like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's cool.
Shaking and a grinning. He was just smiling.
In theory, it says theorized. Well, in theory, it's theorized. Yeah, that too. This is quite itchy.
Bless its heart. So it's feeling good.
So once all this stuff gets off of him, he'll be feeling better. Well, looks like I just did most of the hard work. Oh, got some more down here.
Yeah, this is a non-releasable turtle.
Oh, yeah.
Or resin and release. Just kidding, honey.
Anyway, all this is going to come off over time.
With Dr. Ann.
I think this would be a great new pet for her. Dr. Ann, this is your new friend. She's going to live with you and Abigail forever.
Abigail said today, she goes, I said, your duck still following you around? She goes, yep, and you hear.
Which duck is that?
The baby duck that we gave her.
Oh, sweet. That looks like a good stress reliever.
I was stressed.
But no. No, the turtle's not itchy, so we're going to be stress muscles.
Okay. Anyway, this is what this will continue for another hour, I'm sure.
This is NBL for no back legs. This ripe old gentleman was in the Vietnam War.
November, Bravo, Lima.
I needed that. That was a good one. This is scar tissue. I'm not so sure about being born without legs. This is probably one of those cases where he was crossing the road, car came by and just clamped down so tightly that it just amputated both his legs at the same time.
He's doing so good, though. He's a great educational critter.
Bubba's little legs was kicking. I can't feel my legs. Bubba, you ain't got no legs.
That's not amusing.
Whatever.
No, it's from a movie. Remember Major Payne?
It's true. He's
telling
yes.
the story to the little kid. Boo! Kid screams.
We're exhausted. It's about 12 o'clock at night.
This guy's heavy. This is an old male. He's a real old guy.
That's because my mama feeds him so well. Have you seen an underweight turtle here yet?
No, I haven't actually.
So. I got a fine diet of blue plate mayonnaise and Krispy Kreme donuts. Not true. Just joking.
Tato Nut just opened back today, too.
They were closed?
I'm boycotting.
For what?
I don't know.
They do that every once in a while.
For 2 months. I'm going to get Tato Nuts tomorrow.
I guess making meth is a little more profitable to grind that away a little bit. All right, another Terrapin, Carolina. This guy's, let go. Let go. Let go. Okay.
That was a significant injury.
Oh, yeah.
We're good at this, you know?
Quit tooting your own horn.
Well, I'm tooting his horn, too, because this is because of both of us. This is some hard work here.
That's right. It's team. It's a team effort. Shut up.
He's just jealous. He can't stand it.
All right, you two break it up. Okay, anyway, Terrapin, Carolina. This is a rather old male as well. This guy needs a better diet because if you'll notice, his little beak hair is a little on the overgrown side. We might be able to fix that tonight.
He's buck tooth. Leave him alone. Quit
picking up. So cute.
But when we do this sequestrum control stuff and grind these things away, as these guys are walking through the woods, he can come across a stick or a twig that would get stuck in that little line there. And that would stop him from moving and get him stuck, and he would die some gruesome death stuck somewhere. So, you know, some of the reasons we want to grind this away and make it smoother. So if we're going to release him, that would be what I'd recommend. So we'd probably grind this away, keep him in an outside pen somewhere, you know, your new parole pen. And and after about a few months and the sequestrum falls off, then it's got to be completely releasable.
That's awesome. That's been a long, about a 5-year rehab right there. That's pretty impressive. That purpling on the shell, though, is it okay?
Could be purple coat.
Mm-mm. It's fine.
Sweet.
Where'd the Dremel tool go?
Well, do you want to do that now? Or do you want us to bring him? We can just bring all of them to the clinic. That way we can get
it. Okay, we'll do it all done. Yeah. We'll bring him in with you, and we'll do a big trim on him. Okay. Here we have another, not too old male, but this guy's got the really cool red eyes. It's awesome.
He's also been in a forest fire, too, and been hit by a car. You could see them melting on the other side.
And it could be. Anyway, yeah, we don't know exactly what happened to this guy, or do we? You guessing? Well, that's a good guess.
Came to us with a hit by a car, but
his... And, this has been ground away. This looks like one of the surgeries he did a while back. Mm-hmm. All this is healed in. This is actually quite hard. What happens is once this the granulation tissue sets in, then it actually covers itself with the keratin coat, like the nail stuff that covers your nails. And then there's a mild amount of calcium in here, but it never actually replaces itself with true shell. It's just kind of like a fibrous cartilage type tissue that has some calcium matrix to it. So anyway, this guy's got some sequestrums.
It's like a backup plan.
Yeah. There you go. There's a falling off. And this guy can be released. This guy just needs to go someplace where no other dogs can chew on him or whatever caused these old injuries.
So I could take him deep into the DeSoto.
Well, DeSoto is going to have creatures that could chew on him.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
I'm talking like somebody's sanctuary yard. You know, somebody who's got a...
That would be a good one. The place over there in Pascooler. Has the that big pond with all the geese in it.
Scranton Nature Center.
They have an indoor. They have that area where the peacock is that they is totally enclosed.
But that's not big enough for... Well, it could put one turtle in there. Yeah. But, yeah.
His eyes are brilliant. That's awesome.
Isn't that awesome? It's a good looking one, huh? Oh, that'd be pretty.
Yeah, I love the red eye ones. It's so cool.
He's going to be set free before long.
Miraculously, another Terrapin Carolina. Another male. Eyes not quite so pretty. Sorry, dude. You just can't be dating. Anyway, this guy's got this humongous hole in the shell. It was recommended that we go ahead and spill this with resin and then send it on. And before I got an answer or then, I said, just turn the video on so I can do it all at the same time. Anyway, the reason you don't want to do that, okay, is because inside of here is bound to be all kinds of weird bacteria and probably even some fungal stuff. I mean, this is protein. There could be some athlete-type foot fungus in it that likes to do proteins. Okay. And if you seal it underneath here, you're going to create a gram-negative anaerobic environment, and any infection that happens is going to go down instead of back out.
Okay.
So you don't want to do that unless you have some kind of sensor or made a glass and you can watch through it and monitor it. But anyway, what I would do is get this guy sedated, smooth all this stuff down, grind that down to about there, okay?
So it's smooth.
So it's nice and smooth. And then when that heals in, you can set this guy free.
Okay.
And he would not be worried about any secondary infections and stuff that we would cause.
Sweet. Okay. So unless we had a yard to put him in where there's nothing like that, could he be released just like this?
As long as somebody were monitoring him, could wash it every now and then, you know, and keep him, make sure there's nothing going on. But at some...
Maybe past, we'll talk to Moe's.
With
their new place, maybe they'll have an area.
That'd be awesome. Okay, but basically, we should go ahead and do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you don't know where he's going to be, you know, 10 years from now. And if this were... This, we'd be bringing him back for maggots later on.
Gotcha. We can do it. All right.
All right, another Terrapin Carolina. Big old female. Ooh, Bertha's got butt. this one had cracks in here. This is one of the ones I was using my sequestrum control technique. What happens is these were all very, very deep cracks into the shell and actually went to the periosteum. So where it was fractured, I actually ground down right to the periosteum until it bled at the actual edge. What it does is as this heals, you'll be able to monitor anything that's happening inside these cracks. In other words, if there was an infection, if there was a crack over here and it wasn't ground, it could be an infection beneath the shell and you would not know. So years from now, this turtle could be in gobs and gobs of pain as an infection is going down inside the turtle. Okay, here it gives it a path of least resistance, so any infection where that fracture is actually comes out instead of going in.
How cool is
that? Okay,
that is pretty awesome.
One day I'm gonna write this up.
Kind of like a drain tube, kind of,
but maybe I don't have to write it up anymore because I just did this thing on the video.
No, we'll get National Geographic involved.
But anyway, we'll do is right now it looks like it's time actually for some sequester removal.
Now this turtle to me is ready for release soon.
If not tomorrow.
Well, no. But once we get her back in and you dremel a lot of this down,
it's done. It's dremeled.
This is done.
Oh,
so he's saying that everything's done, and he's just.
Oh.
Saying that you needed to
see that little white piece of bone right there. Okay, that's the sequestrum that needs to come off. Okay, what happens is since I've ground down, I know that the infection is not deep inside this turtle, and that's why you only like the other pieces. That other turtle that had the big chunks, I was pulling off a large chunk of bone.
Dr. Ann turtle.
The Dr. Ann's gonna accost turtle. Anyway, and. You use the wire here to keep all this together, you know, and make sure it was nice and tight. So what's going to happen is once this stuff falls off, it's going to be the hard protein coat beneath it, and it'll be impervious to the maggots and so forth.
And ready to go.
Yeah.
I like it. You ready to be free and go have some babies?
And I think this will probably come off now. I just don't have my dental picks with me. I'm trying to get a piece to pop off just for the camera while we're watching. And It's not gonna come.
You want two hands? I'll hold her. Or we'll...
Sure, try it.
There's a slew of tools behind you too, if you want something.
I don't think they have. Is back there what he's looking for, though?
Well, there's a pair of scissors I can ruin, so. Don't pee on the doctor. See how that comes off?
Look at that.
So that is relatively fresh shell underneath it. And once all that stuff is out of there, this one we give the doctor in for sure. Yeah, this is frustrating even for me.
And she would sit and pick, won't she?
Oh yeah, she would. Yeah, we'll give that to her. Okay, that's one we can bring back to her.
Dr. Ann, you got two pets, Dr. Ann.
Hit by car, leg, and hinge check. That was March 15th he came in.
His eyes swollen up.
They actually have two eyes. He said he has an eye. Come on, that was funny.
I'm laughing. You hear me? I'm laughing. Come on, come out. Come on, come out. Wherever you are. I know you're in there. Come on, pokey, pokey, pokey.
Oh, that was the face smasher.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, all right. So, as you see while you're hiding.
Tears of goo. Oh, God. Now, this is what it looks like?
That should be a euthanasia case outfit. What do you think?
Yeah, them eyes are swole after March 15th was the hit day.
Mm. Well, euthanize or sedate him and get a better look.
He's been here since March. What's
next? Has it eaten?
Well, she'd been feet. I think he'd be dead by now. What's his weight feel like to you?
It actually feels pretty heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he eats.
All right, so anyway, this one, we can pry our way in here. Has some other swollen periorbital sockets. I can see some maxillary fractures. I thought I saw a mandibular fracture as well. It's not too displaced for these guys to survive, or even eat for that matter, you know, if this guy has been actually been eating. But anyway, what I would want to do is sedate this guy, get a better look, and see if there's something else we could do for him. And because it is kind of late in the game for any true reconstructive surgery.
Right.
Yeah, that's an old turtle.
That's yeah, and he too. Definitely needs a fecal done.
Beautiful.
Okay. So,
all right.
Where is that coming from?
Let me get you a
all right, it's coming from his butt.
Let me get you a
okay, let's get scheduled for release at Tina and Phillip. So, if Tina and Phillip are watching, we're giving him the free to go. Tina and Phillip, when you get them back, you may want to get some fingernail polish remover and take this stuff off of here. They say possession is 9/10 of the law, and somewhere there's some kid who's got a picture of this turtle and went, "He's my baby turtle."
Yeah, she's an attorney. She'd be like, "That's mine."
She probably put up a bigger fight than most people. I'll give her that part. But if she's in front of some kid and some judge sees a picture of him going, "He's my baby turtle," then the kid might win. So clean this stuff off of here, you know, a little bit of fingernail polish remover, just get that off of there. That way there's no permanent marks because possession is 9/10 of the law and someone owned this before or
that belongs claimed to it the before. State of Mississippi.
Well, maybe true, but you know, being a lawyer and a person in business, she doesn't want to be stealing some baby's turtle. Did we have to say her name and tell what her profession she was?
Well, yeah. We did.
Ordinarily, I try to keep my clients out of these videos, you know, just in case. But anyway, so point being is when you get it back, try to clean this stuff off. If we don't, then Doug is going to Dremel it off, and we know what his power tools can do.
Whoa. All right, there we go.
All right, to be released.
Okay, do that again, boys.
No. It's from the buzzard, from the...
I already don't know. My mama done told me.
Find something for dinner.
All right. I've met this guy once before.
Wait, let's see.
He's got a massive overbite, folks.
Look, he's like, y'all got me some dinner?
Look, y'all, do not use chewing tobacco. It's bad for your turtle's health.
This was a skull man back in the day. All right, I met this guy once before. We call him No Jaw. He's actually a very cool tortoise. We don't know what happened to him. But if you look really, really closely, you can tell that most of his mandible is completely missing. And I can't get him to do it. Maybe I can do this. He'll open his mouth when he's upside down.
He Come eats on. With his little tongue. It's the cutest thing in the world.
Why don't you open his head in a minute? He tries to go over, but he'll use his nose. Hello, the backstroke. This is how you do the backstroke.
God, he's cute.
And he's peeing.
Hold on.
Now we gotta be careful though. This guy's beak here, since it has no apposition, is gonna get overly long.
Okay.
So when he starts having a hard time eating, we should probably go back. See, there you go. The exit opened right there.
His head looks like a little snail.
See him pushing. So you can see his jaw open right there as best it can. He's got a little bit of mandible left, but he doesn't have any that the keratin sticks to.
Do I need to clean any of that out? No,
I cleaned the pee off my lap.
Right there, I mean, underneath.
I don't know.
Like a dental? You know what I'm saying?
No, it's just food.
Okay.
He does eat very well. How does his weight feel to you?
He's not the heaviest turtle we held today, but he's actually got a good weight. Mm-hmm. But this is actually a very cool turtle. We saw him, I guess it was pretty soon after his injury. It was still pretty healed, so we just opted to keep this guy for educational purposes. And
he's got the cutest little face. He does. Look. His little profile right there is just adorable.
No.
Right there.
No.
Okay.
Because you just got to put up and we're good. You're videoing? Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. This one we saw a while back. I could tell I'd worked on him because I was right there weight on the bottom. That way I know how they left me and how much they weighed before I used the anesthesia and how much to use.
Let's see if he's gained anything, just for the fun of it.
Okay.
829 grams then?
He was 822.
822. Let's see what he is now. Yeah, he's dropped a little bit.
Yes, 814. Well, that could have been the leg.
Oh.
we removed actually 7 grams a leg.
That was a good one.
All right, Doug, your mission, hold turtle just like that.
Like this.
We released several three-legged ones a few weeks ago, and they just took off beautifully. We released, 27 turtles?
Mm-hmm.
That's impressive, you know?
And we still have all these.
It's still impressive.
I'm not complaining. I'm saying that's pretty cool that we've got all these turtles under our care.
Yeah. And we're going to release quite a few of them.
He didn't answer. He ignores your call.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. Taking out sutures. Oh. And an amputated leg.
Did it come out? Yeah. I guess it did.
One did, but there's a little thread back there still. You see it? Behind? Right there.
I can't see.
There. Yeah. I don't know if that's just healed into the scab. Yeah, there it is.
God,
there's the other knot.
You sound like Russell Crowe. Did you hear how he said it?
Yeah, it didn't sound like Russell Crowe.
He did for a minute. He did.
Is he rich?
Yes.
Is he handsome?
Yes.
I'm all for it.
He was the guy that played Gladiator.
No, I'm thinking of who's the dude that Josh always talks. Russell Brand.
Oh.
That's who I'm talking about.
Ooh.
Not Russell Crowe.
So I was right. It didn't sound like Russell Crowe.
No, smart butt. It's
wow.
Like the other one.
Wow. All I did was say I was right.
You guys are awesome.
We are pretty cool.
No, I'm sick of him. I just want to punch him in the face.
You would miss this guy.
Excuse me while she missed this guy.
Oh, Lord have mercy. Note to self.
Guitar didn't, solo here.
Didn't know that was
a song. Oh, you can see the bone. Purple haze?
I don't know what that is.
You are so sheltered.
Excuse me while I eat this fly. You know that song?
No. I don't think I want to know that song either. Eating flies?
Oh, my goodness.
That wasn't really the words, but thank you for taking it one step farther.
It's like, oh, it hurts. Oh, Doc, oh, I'm not going to make it. Hold me.
It does look like drama right there.
Hold me. Oh, God.
That was Doug's Sunday night.
I'm fainting.
At the hospital.
It's getting dark.
It's getting dark. Are y'all done, y'all bunch of clowns?
That was perfect.
It was good. I liked it.
His little eye looked pretty.
Well, he's but when he seals
out,
well.
Yeah, but when he gets out in the wild, he will do better.
He had some damage up there, too, but that's all healing pretty good.
Can we release?
Yes, this guy's a releaser.
What about his not neck? It says maggots in the neck. I do not want to release with maggots. If there's
you maggots. Need maggots anyways.
I got this. We haven't seen any. I'm disappointed. I even brought maggot stuff.
Well, that means we're doing good.
No, you haven't got Turtle Man yet. Where's his mandible?
Right there.
Oh, okay.
Rah, 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 con. The turtle whisperer says, open your face.
Open sesame seed bun.
Right, Daddy on here and release.
Gee, chicky, chicky, chicky.
Yeah, just.
I ain't ticklish, yeah, motherfucker.
Got a fat roll, dude.
This is not one of our local ones.
No, it's not.
Where's this guy from?
Don't know. People bring stuff to us, and there's no telling where
I would say.
From. He's not a releasable one.
I'd say Northeast.
Pretty though, huh?
Somebody might have brought it back from vacation and let it go.
It's awfully red.
You know what I mean? Maybe it's from Georgia.
Very unique, Daddy. Huh?
Daddy. Yeah.
This is gonna be it. This one I've had forever and a day. Why is this one being? Oh, just because his eyes.
Yeah, eye issues.
Okay.
Has he always had eye issues, or is this just something new?
I don't know. He's never had, basically, I don't know how long he's had these. My mom's been taking care of these. She just wrote eye issues on there. But I don't see, do you see eye issues?
He's got conjunctivitis.
Okay.
Well, we could but I mean, that, if he's a Midwestern species of tortoise, I need to look this guy up. If he's a Midwestern species of tortoise, the humidity here could do that in itself. Of course, if he's also Midwestern, he could be coming here with mycoplasma, and that could be mycoplasma, sons of mycoplasma.
I could take him back to Michigan when I go in June.
You are not crossing state lines with wildlife, and you know better.
Or Northeast. You can look him up. You need to spend some time in the turtle books.
Yeah.
His shell's
ugly. How long his
ugly.
Back nails are.
I think his shell's pretty. You take that back.
Nah.
Yeah, he's.
Yeah, those legs.
And I want to tell you,
those nails aren't normal.
No, I think it's a three-toed box, but I don't know from what species. But look, this he's gotten much redder over the past few years. Much redder. That's a pretty tortoise. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, but he's a not releasable tortoise because.
Not releasable. What I would want to try next is get him in some tetracycline soaks and see if that makes a difference in his eyes.
Tetracycline soaks.
That is wicked.
Mm-hmm.
The white specks.
You like that word now, don't you?
Wicked cool.
That's maggot poop.
All right. Somehow, in this guy's initial injury when he was hit by a car, it actually had injured the hinge. This is actually quite a complicated hinge when you think about bones and how they work. And the fact that this one here... And the species is hinged here. Well, it's hinged across here, and each individual flap closes up, which means it also has a little bit of a hinge capability right in here, over here, here, as well as this long, big one. Anyway, the bad news of this one was when we first saw it, is it was red and irritated in here, and it was chock full of maggots. The large kind of maggots that I've been trying to collect to figure out what they were. And I still see maggots in there, but I'm not convinced of the same thing. Anyway, not that I'm a maggot expert yet, but we need to grind this away because that's one of the reasons you want to grind these things. You can't manage that wound if it's that closed.
Gotcha.
Okay, you can't see what's inside. Every time we clean the maggots out, another fly comes and lays the eggs.
There could be maggots all the way back up in here.
Well, we didn't list one. This was kind of cool for this case is we actually put some rhenografin inside there.
I remember that. That's right.
So we actually put, was it barium or rhenografin? I forget. Mm-hmm. One of those barium. Inside of here and took x-rays and then to see how deep it went.
Yeah,
it was actually
right.
A pocket about that deep and about that wide.
Remember I brought the x-ray back and it had the barium in it?
Let's do that again.
We can. We have technology. So we probably will do that again, and then we'll grind this out. So this guy's when we bring to the hospital.
We might have the technology, bud, but we cannot make you fast.
So we can make him faster. Do no 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 do no 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 do 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 no 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 no. Does this guy have any history I should know about pertinent?
That's Turtle Man. That's Robin Bush's turtle.
Oh, okay.
Maggots.
He's ready to go home back to Robin Bush. There's still a couple maggots in his neck. We saved them for you.
Did you? Oh, you're so and if nice. You,
yeah, we were able to get this and grab them.
He also has sequestrums, so we'll pluck a few more of these off before he goes back. But obviously, this guy was probably a chew toy or some kind of other injury. Could be burnt.
Potato chip.
They're really chewy ones.
It's a dinosaur potato chip. But turtle chip. That was pretty funny. I'm proud of you.
Douglas, sometimes I can be funny, and it's but I rare, don't want to yes. be because you drive me so crazy. I have to be serious or you'll never be serious.
What's that?
I know, right?
That's her psychosis.
Unlike most women, I don't have psychosis.
Whoa! What's sad is...
It's in her DNA.
She said, unlike most women. So, you women who've heard this, you know where to place the next bomb.
Most women are crazy. I am not.
All females are crazy. It's the unbalance of estrogen.
You just don't know which chemical's thinking for you yet.
Right.
It's okay. We love you.
Yeah. Wouldn't change a thing.
I would probably... Ow, my eye. I would probably have some automatic button, you know, like which... Like the remote control. Which chemical do you want out? Like we get home from work, we hit the estrogen button.
Look how much better he looks. Yeah, they called me to get my surgery pre-op for June. I canceled it.
But why?
I said, I'll call y'all back later. I ain't got time for this right now. Why the aggravated looking face, Douglas?
Because you're a chicken.
I'm not doing that right now. I got babies to tend to.
Oh, I don't get the chicken thing.
Because I had a gallbladder surgery. I am not chicken.
Yeah. Why'd you have a gallbladder surgery?
Scaredy cat chicken.
Yes.
Okay, I was done.
Because I had no choice. You made me go the next day. I would have canceled if I could have.
Right.
And my gallbladder was ruptured. And my liver was extremely large. So it was a good thing that I did go.
Same thing for the other thing, but she won't listen. I mean, they're just doctors.
Damn them. All right, Turtle Man, show me your head. I see the swelling.
It's like a turtle head poking out.
He's turtling. Lost that foot. Gotcha.
You pulled his finger, get it?
Just see the thing on Facebook and the girl's like this. She's like, I'll pull a grandpa's finger. Oh, her face looks hilarious. She must have fell in the mud. They just took that and ran with it. This is a long one, by the way.
Okay.
Oh, you found it? The maggot?
Nope.
Did we get them all? Are we in trouble?
Yeah. Bastards. Another Terrapin, Carolina. Hit by a car in the left fender. Serious need of some body work?
Seriously. Left fender.
You guys are good.
She's getting dyed blonde. This
am.
Bleach blonde.
No.
No, your voice was, not you.
Yeah, that was somebody else talking.
Has that mended back together?
That was the pod girl.
Does that have a good blood supply? It's good and stable, pretty much?
It ain't moving.
Isn't that cool?
Get away.
It needs to be scrubbed.
Scrub girl.
My eye.
Stop. Get away. It keeps going like this. Stuart.
Look what I can do.
Yeah.
Look at Shaking turtle syndrome.
How can I do? You've never seen Mad TV? Oh, he's the best.
I don't know what that is.
Stuart!
Y'all are scaring me. Y'all are a bunch of weirdos.
Look what I can do.
You just laugh it up.
Mm-hmm. It's late. I'm sorry.
God, your face is so red. Is it
hot?
It
is red.
Does it feel hot?
No. No. Is it hot? Is it? No. She's shaking her head. No. Oh, I'm crushed.
So is the turtle.
Okay, what are we doing with him?
We're going to scrub him up so you can see what he looks like later on.
Scrub him up, Adibu.
All right, he's a Terrapin Carolina.
From the How old, many times have you said that?
From the old country. He was a wine stamper. had a chronic grape infection.
My God, y'all are so delirious. I think it's because you said...
Terrapin Carolina.
He thought if he
100 times.
He thought if he drank some Gatorade, he'd go faster.
I know, Addy.
Before the camera started, there was even Barney rape jokes, so it was much worse.
Grimace.
Well, you didn't say
Grimace
Barney, too.
But yeah. Grimace is funnier.
Oh, Lord. I'm not in this conversation. I'm just holding the video.
Poor Grimace.
What the hell
Poor
did
turtle
that?
Got lured out with some french fries, and Grimace went to town.
I'm telling you, people go crazy with that purple coat stuff in the country.
I've just never seen it stick like this.
Oh, that stuff ain't coming off.
Do you know what it does?
Spray him in the arm real quick. See.
Let me do it.
No.
Yes.
Give him my arm.
It'll be good for you.
It'd be fun
good for me.
It'd be fun.
It'll make you a man.
All the chicks think purple coat.
But seriously, so... Some of them, it's antibacterial, antifungal. It does the same thing. And
so is gasoline, but you don't put this stuff on every wound.
Well, in the country they do.
Well, you know what's funnier? We keep calling it purple coat, but it's actually blue coat.
Yeah.
But it's purple when it comes out.
Okay. No, you leave it in the can. Go away from me.
Dad. Father.
I mean, I know, yeah, but...
We did not do this.
Yeah,
just to let you know.
No purple coat. Leave Barney in the can.
It kills ringworm.
Why we only do this. We only use it on mammals here, and it's really good on mammals.
I mean, Dr. Naylor approves.
All right, this is a releaser. This is definitely a releaser.
All right, yeah.
Let the dating world work out the purple thing.
You know how many turtles are gonna have purple on them?
No, it's obviously a calling out there for him.
Lucy. It is.
You had to give her a name after I just pronounced her.
No, she's been named Lucy. What'd you call her?
Huh?
This is Lucy.
I called her History.
Well, the finders do know that she's probably euthanized.
Okay.
Today, so.
Anyway, it turns out that neurologically speaking, from your brain here to the back end, there's your forebrain, there's a hindbrain, okay? Which is why whenever you see a turtle who's got one of these back injuries, they can feel when their legs get touched back here, but they don't have any power to push it, all right? It's like when When a paraplegic gets those injuries, those back legs, if you were to hit the patella reflex, their knees would still jerk, but yet they don't feel them. They don't know what's going on. All right, well, there's a rare thing called the Schiff-Sherrington syndrome, which I've never seen in a turtle, where actually the hindbrain still works a little bit, but it sends a signal forward that blocks out this one. So in other words, this guy can't feel this, can't move these. You'd think that if there was a problem from here to here, from here to here, this one would still be able to feel and these would not.
Hmm.
So sometimes the injuries actually happen in the brain and in the cervical area that actually causes part of the Schiff-Sherrington syndrome. It's just one of those things that they torture you with in neurology, but you see very rarely. And we diagnosed this just the other day in a dog that we ended up having to put to sleep, but first time I've seen it in a turtle, which I thought that was kind of cool. Sadly, this guy's going to heaven.
Okay, well, hey, we try, but we can't save them all. And it's best to do that than to let them suffer. So. Yes.
Well, now we have a known case of Schiff-Sherrington.
Yeah.
All right. Fire some of that jaw is what I was thinking. Excellent. This thing here was hit.
Up, you'll be able to see better.
How long ago was this one hit?
Do you remember, Doug, how long it was hit?
I'm just trying to hold it up.
Oh, my God. Oh, my gosh. Y'all make me a nervous wreck.
Where Dr. Askew gets his face chewed off.
When animals attack.
Oh, I know.
What? Quit digging your nails into me.
That piece is going to come off. I'm losing. Losing, sorry.
He was chewed on by an alligator.
Could be.
My goodness. Okay, so do we need to...